Hello, everybody. My name is Automath, and welcome to another episode of, well, I would say mod of the day, but it isn't really mod of the day because Wraithnet expansion was the mod of the day 4 days ago. So instead, this is a mod gameplay because I have practiced a little. It's not my first time playing this, and I will do a single lane hard game now. And I will look how far I'm coming. This is a solo Alchemist run. I'm running with the character of Alchemist. I'm not gonna pick anything else. I'm not gonna pick anything for fun. Alchemist is the character of choice here. And we'll see where that gets me. Right. Anyway. I've practiced a few runs with Alchemist. On easy, it's pretty fucking easy to come to wave 25, 26, 27. On hard, not so much. So you gotta, like, try, at least, to make things work. But when I'm not completely fucking up, I think I should get fairly far. Alchemist is the character to solo this with, for obvious reasons. Regeneration, more gold, which is really important, because you're gonna see some serious bullcrap soon in this already. And obviously because of the early game AoE, which will help as well with killing the healing dudes. Because I could just right-click them to submission. It's interesting because it works. Seems like I have a sore throat, which is interesting. I shouldn't have that. I'm just gonna drink something. Just while I'm waiting for the loads. Much better. I hope. At least, I hope I'm not burping at least. Anyway, seems like the loading is complete. I can see by the screen flickering. Oh, here we go. Good. Let's do this.
Choose your hero.
There's some more heroes which really are good in this mode. Not so good solo, but good anyway. So, I want to get Grevils greed first because two bounty runes will always spawn here. And I get 1,000 gold out of it for no reason other than giving me a 1,000 gold. Why not? Unsure about whether or not I should get a mini fury. I think I will skip out on that. But I will get a normal because I'm gonna go for Battle Fury anyway, so I'm gonna get a normal axe. And to punch, is there anything I could pick up early to give me some punch? Let's see. Well, I mean, I could start, I could start with a Battle Fury after all, like, that is not a problem, I guess. Broadsword is giving me a little bit of punch here. It doesn't really matter. What matters is that soon there should be a huge wave of enemies arriving in front of my doorstep. Now the mini fury is only helping for like 2 waves, and it's too much money commitment for me. Because I can think I can handle them anyway. I just press this, and now everything dies already. And as you can see, I'm actually getting money now. 7 gold is the maximum on level 1, which is why I need to level that skill up. But I'm getting money. I'm getting there really fast. It's at least 7 gold. I mean, otherwise this wouldn't be no gold, because if you remember correctly, the only way to get gold is by lasthitting creeps after wave 3. thanks to Alchemists, however, or more importantly Grievous Greed, I don't actually have to do that. I just have to, like, kill creeps, basically. Yeah. Nothing more to it, except that. And because I'm doing an incredible job at killing creeps apparently, they will all die. They too will die, now I can heal up, like this. I mean mana up. Now I can put another here, and now even more creeps should be dying. There's a healing self. I need that. So there's the first healer. He becomes kind of interesting. Because he makes things legitimately a little bit harder. So the best way to get rid of the healer is by simply getting a claymore. And because I am low on mana, I'm gonna get a mango. Gonna consume that mango, lay this down, and beat up those things right here. Because they have minus armor, I can beat them up easily. Pretty much. It's not too hard. So the first tower is almost lost, but I will still be trying to get an acid spray here. Now, I could have optimized my money gain by just getting another... Oh, wow. That was unexpected. I could have optimized my money gain, and I need to get here. There's so much gold lying around. By just, like, you know, pressing another point into... Oh, fuck me. That was a failed buyback. By just pressing, you know, another point into Grievous Greed instead of this acid spray. But I wasn't sure if a level 2 acid spray would be enough. Last time I tried, it was a level higher, so it wasn't a big problem. I don't know why I was a level higher, though. That is, like, something I don't understand till today. Assumedly so, it doesn't really matter. Here we go, we drop another acid spray, level up the gold gain, and then we just beat up on monsters for the whole intents and purposes of the first wave. It's not... Oh my god, I got stuck. Oh, I need to get out. Fuck. Is this cost... Yeah, this is costing. This is a really costing death right here, because I shouldn't have died. Ugh. I'm thinking about restarting this. No, actually not. This is just a costing death, because I am losing so much gold. I could have had my Battle Fury. But it's gonna take a while for the towers to kill all the remaining creeps anyway, because they have still some healers up. It's not a big problem after all.
Well, that has changed. Your middle tower is fighting for its life.
Actually, when I think about it, it might be impossible for the towers to get everything down in time. I will definitely respawn and be able to collect experience and gold. Now, that was a mistake of my part that shouldn't have happened. But I'm not saying that this, like, something that I can't get out of again. It's just something that is very unfortunate that it happened. Like, I shouldn't have died there. It's that easy. I could have not died there, but I was getting stuck because I was greedy for the runes and shit. But on the contrary, now I have my Battle Fury, so that is perfect, perfect, absolutely perfect. Now, after the Battle Fury, I will get some what, Amulet of Mudigan maybe? Are we sure? Actually, never mind. I was thinking I need the Radiance first, so I want to get a Radiance. Oh, make no mistakes, by the way. Alchemist cannot get those zombies completely down. Oh, he can, actually, never mind. But last time I tried, for some reason, it didn't quite work. Anyway, now the next item is going to be this absolutely beautiful Radiance, because that is going to help a lot, especially because you can upgrade it again. You can upgrade the Radiance twice here, which makes it absolutely strong. Way too good for it not to be picked up. The zombie wave is fun, because if I drop this and come close, the zombie master would start spawning stuff. And that spawn stuff will also give me money. Like this. In other words, this wave is an absolute gold maker for Alchemist players. Alchemist is without a doubt not even bad in multiplayer. Like, I think he is even stronger on the 5-lane map, because he can get a lane alone. And all lanes are roughly the same sense. He doesn't have to wait. He works at co-op as well. A friend of mine played him, actually. I think he messed a little bit up on the item build, but other than that, we were coming quite high. I'm gonna cut some trees and take some more monsters here. Just to make it feel faster. And so I can have my Radiance earlier. So right now I have two problems. First of all, I'm not on the level yet that would be required for this to be working with utmost efficiency. Second, I don't have a higher level ulti right now. Now, one of those problems gonna change very soon. I will, without a doubt, have a higher level ulti very, very fast. However, I would still lack a few items, because I'm going for, like, the Radiance and everything else. That means I'm not gonna get attack speed anytime soon. No, the attack speed itself is not a big problem. I assume we can without a problem get it later and not feel too much from it. What will be a problem, however, and that's gonna be a big issue, is the fact that I will be needing a very that's why I'm sure not sure if, like, the first wave was important or not. To the next wave, I actually need some kind of, like, experience. Level ups are very important in this game mode early on, Later they are also important, but not as important as early on. Really, that is, I think, a no-brainer. But right now, leveled up is our most important thing, just because higher level ultimates, higher base stats, which is really important, armor, agility, attack speed, all of that things, they increase gradually every level. The stun is not so important. I'm mostly only using it against bosses. But the bosses are not really stunned for long, it's just a little bit more damage, and the damage is already very minuscule anyway. So I'm only getting it really, so I can just skirt stats later without it being an annoyance, without temptation, because it's usually just an annoyance. You can skill it, but you don't have to, and game allows you to skill it. It's just, I will miss that at one point, and every point will be wasted, and so I'd rather get it early and have some use than not getting it at all and having no use for it, and accidentally skilling it when I could have skilled stats. Both is fair and dandy, to be honest. Alright, so, you can upgrade the Radiance, as I said before. Not gonna do that, though. Importance is the Octarine Core. Octarine Core is just for the permanent ultimate, basically. Such an important item. I'm fairly glad that I will most likely have it before the waves ends, because that means that because I have the Octarine Core, I can do the next wave without problems. It's that simple, really. It makes me tanky. And I have a permanent ultimate, which is also absolutely great. Right, now let's get back. I only have a few seconds before the next round starts, so let's cut the tree, get a little bit back a little bit faster, and now I'm gonna invest in a courier. I will need a courier later for item ferrying, so no point not investing in it now. The next wave is the Ogres. This is why I want the Octarine Core. I want to be a little bit more tanky, because in reality, the Ogre bosses still hurt a ton and can kill me. But if I have an Octarine Core and my ulti is on, the chances of one killing me is fairly low. Chances of more than one killing me is fucking high. Which is why I hope I'm not gonna get fucked, pretty much. Right, it's the same story again. We are just waiting here. Now, what are the boots of the choice here? Now, the best boots you can get, without a doubt, are Guardian Greaves, because of the item which is called the Besiege Mail, which requires a mysterious orb, which is not yet available for me to buy it. So, no point in doing that. But I will most likely get Guardian Greaves anyway, just to prepare. Because I will have so much money, I can later just simply buy those mysterious orbs. Guardian Greaves right now are a lot more expensive. I need some attack speed, so I mean, why not get one? You know, a little bit of attack speed. Now, what I'm not aware of is a bigger basher or not. There isn't. A basher also very important, because high attack speed, basically. The attack speed of choice, and this is the Assault Cuirass. As I said later, you can combine it with boots. To make it stronger. I will also get a Mjolnir, that's important, and a Bash, and I will consume a Immune Shard, and then I have my 6 level item build. After the Assault Cuirass, however, I will get a higher level of my beautiful Radiance, which is called the Hijawa Sword. So right now this is a way where I can use the stun, that's why I'm getting it now, because later it would be kind of useless, but right now I can just do this, and it still doesn't do a lot, except for some damage. Which is needed. Well, as you however can see, as Dr. Rico helps me to tank through this, chances of dying is very low if I would start dodging now, and I should. So I'm gonna drop down a little bit of acid here, wait till that punches run out, and then just kill the monster. Easy going. Seems like something has blocked them somewhere. Oh yeah. This guy is really, really, really slow this time. So I have to probably go there manually and finish that guy off manually, because otherwise I'm gonna wait for ages. And I have a lot of ideas about how I want to play this mod. Waiting for 20 minutes is not one of them. So let's find our way into that direction. Because I have a courier, I can get the Assault Cuirass, and I'm still at him. So let's do this to end the TP while I'm at it.
Gonna fit on you.
You heard him. For some reason, the opponents are really slow this wave. Oh, no, they're getting faster. Seems to be a problem with custom mods. Legion Tower Defense has the same problem with the Techies Wave. I don't know what causes it, but it would be nice to figure that out. So now, without a doubt, I'm making a lot of minus armor. If I drop an acid spray at least, things should die really, really quickly. I don't want to be hit by this. I have to consider lifesteal at one point. And the lifesteal of my choice, and that's very interesting, will be a Vladimir's offering. Now you will maybe wonder, why Vladimir's? Why not something that is more strong, like a Mask of Madness, maybe? The answer is really fast, satanic, but the answer is easy, because there is a Vladimir's upgrade which gives 60% base damage. That's a lot of base damage. I definitely want that later. But as I said, now I have my AC. What is important right now is gonna be that 60 upgrade for my Radiance, which is basically just another Radiance. I just have to buy another Radiance. It's that simple. So let's do that. Prepare for a second Radiance. I have a little bit of armor now. That helps me tank it through auto hits, which is important for bosses. I will probably farm the Broodmother Wraith a little bit, not too much, because I'm getting a lot of money from the Broodmother Wraith. It's insane. Battle Fury can later be upgraded, that's why I'm not gonna sell it, but Battle Fury is an item I will not keep. Battle Fury will be sold most likely for something more useful. But later I will reacquire it when it gets actually very strong. Now, usually I don't go Battle Fury Alchemist, it's so stupid, but this is because of Wrath Knight itself favors Battle Furies over other items. I mean, look at how strong it is. I mean, it's just such a good item in this game mode, really. That being said, if you go Alchemist and the Blade Fury, you are idiots. Basically, don't do it. I mean, you can do it if you want to, but you will feel like an idiot for doing it. Right, now I have double the burn damage and even more out-to-hit damage. Time for some attack speed. My attack speed is still pretty ridiculous. So, as I said, the Majornia is pretty much safe bet and good in this game mode, so let's do that next. The reason Majornia is so strong is because it too has an upgrade, and that upgrade doesn't even require an orb, which makes it even greater, which is the Stormbreaker, and I will definitely get that. It requires a Majornia plus a Moonshot and a Recipe. It is an interesting and really, really great item to get. And again, enemies have been stuck, so I gotta go for them. I don't know what causes this. Courier, come to me, give me another TP. The TP is really only so I can get back in position before it's too late. And so I'm not missing the runes. Which I'm hopefully not missing. Not if I hurry. Next round in a few seconds, which should be, if I'm not mistaken, the... Oh yeah, the red prophet. You can farm this a lot, and the way you farm this is really easy. First of all, I have to get away from here because this is not the best spot for it. I have to kill those two prophets, and okay, I have to collect all the money as well, obviously. Hey, fuck me, that always happens. And you have to open a very certain location on the map, and luckily the safe rune is gonna assist me in coming to that really quick. So let's do it. The location you have to open for this to efficiently work is right here, actually.
Your middle tower is under attack.
Because if you open that up, then the prophets will keep spamming shit on you. And chances are they will not die. I can open up here as well, it's not too late yet.
Your middle tower is fighting for its life. Your middle tower has fallen for hard times. Dead times, in fact.
The prophets will... Don't get me wrong, the prophets will die. But it's gonna help me a little bit because it's giving me some more money. It's not a big help, it's a little bit of help. And as you can see, they are fucking infuriating. I have to defend my base now actually, can't farm even if I would want to. Oh you guys, not funny. Really not funny actually. Now this is why the Mjolnir is great, because everything just keeps killing itself. It's pretty simple, isn't it? Everything kills each other. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. Alright, so now I only need one more Hyperstone and then I have the Stormbearer. Which is obviously completely great. Burn Notice. Oh, this is this one. Oh my god, they one shot when they hit that. And I wasn't aware of that, that they spawn right here. Usually they don't. Luckily this wave is over really fast, so I don't have to worry too much. Oh no, it's again, something stuck. I'm just gonna travel there, I cut a tree and kill them preemptively. Why is everything getting stuck? Let's go. Pour it on. Down the hat, bar. Candy bars. So now I should have a nice fair bit of attack speed. I will consume Moonshot too, but as I said, I need a Vladimir's Offering and I need to get rid of my Battle Fury for a bash. And then I should get Roshan, get a Divine Rapier, which I will replace with the Assault Cuirass for now. But later I will maybe not Assault Cuirass, maybe a different item. Well, most likely I will replace it for the Heal Assault, because let's face it, the damage is gonna fall off very soon. The Blue Mother Wave is the real actual wave which still works with that, and after that I don't really need it as much. I can replace that with basically this sword right here, which is a lot of fucking damage. It's just a huge damage increase, and it's just a good item to have. I should kill Roshan as fast as I can, actually. Maybe I can do it during the Broodmother wave. I'm not sure, actually. If I can, it becomes imperative not to die. Yeah, I can. Without a problem, I can even. It's becoming imperative that I don't die with the Aegis on me. That is absolutely imperative. If I die without the Aegis on me... Well, I have to invest in that upgrade just really fast now. That's all. I have to get that before I get Lats. Halloween Tide, this is this item. I need that item. Hey, Root Mama, what are you doing? At least Root Mama is not gonna kill me, as you maybe can see. But I shouldn't be killing Root Mama too, because Root Mama is something like endless wealth, basically. As you can see, I can just do this, and, well, I'm rich, basically. How could you let that happen? And as you know, I need a Divine Rapier, so doing that might as well help. I'm gonna give myself this. Killing all those eggs. Really quick. Oh, more eggs. Perfect. Just grandiose. And now I'm gonna kill all those spiders. Broodmother can the thing with this here is the Broodmother can chase me compared to like my Emberspirit run. Nothing is happening too hard here. I just need some more money. That's why I'm not killing Broodmother. Broodmother died. Fuck. Hey, you're making me spill. Oh my shitty god! I have to go there really quick and collect all those bags of gold. No. Ah, fuck you, game. Right. The problem is I just have to like really carry on with the Roshan token and get some more gold in really quick. How much more? A lot. Oh, because I wanted to play smart. Kind of regretting that right now, to be honest. What's the next wave? I hope it's a spamming wave. Let's hope it's a wave that helps. Solving a lot of financial problems that I might have. Compound interest. Oh yeah, right, that's the... Oh no, that's the gyrocopter wave, isn't it? Oh my greatness. No, it is not. This is a good way for money farming, actually. Oh. This is actually really fucking bad right here. How lucky am I that they come back to me because I'm the mother or something? No. I have a rapier and I have an Aegis. I'm not able to keep it for long, so I have to hurry. 5 minutes are over soon. I'm not taking any of that. Bullshit. Oh, that's a lot of money you can gain. They'll come from here because I opened the way up and because he's running like that, so I'm gonna fucking kill him there.
Your middle tower is under attack.
Killing the next mutt giant, if I may call him like that, here should also be a pretty nice chest. Where is the money? Oh, I've actually collected already. Perfect. So now the last two men will come there. It's fine. I can deal with that. How could you let that happen? Go fuck yourself. Oh, that's actually a few more than two, which is good because that means more money. Great. Now I have the holotide rapier, which, as I said, is kind of fucking up my build order a little bit. It's time for the Let Me Use Offering then. Hey, what the hell are you doing? But fun things, Vladimir's is not very expensive, I can actually get one. But as I said, a Battlefury can be used later, so I'm not gonna, like, waste it. I'm just gonna keep it for now in case I need a little bit more money. And we'll get Vladimir's. Now, time for the consumables, which is, if I recall correctly, starts with a moonshot. Bearforce, oh yeah, that one. Is this still open? Yeah, that should be... What is wrong with this motto day? Jesus.
Pour it on. That stuff burns.
I'm just gonna make sure that I run faster.
Your middle tower is fighting for its life.
Insane. Everything is running badly right now.
Radiant's courier has been slain. The gentle herald.
I slayed it on purpose because I wanted to know whether or not he could speed up those creep waves himself. The answer is he can't. Right, now time to consume the moon shards. It should give me some more attack speed. Whoop, whoop, I'm perfect. I have a moon shard consumed. That is attack speed for me. Now I'm almost capped on attack speed, which is great. Just great. Just jolly great. Oh, I will be very much faster if I just cut a few trees. I can't cut trees, I don't have a battle fear anymore. So, you know what, while I'm waiting for this, I'm gonna do the first optional boss. I'm just gonna do all the optional bosses now. The first optional boss is right here, it's a Venomancer. You just kill the tower. See, the tower dies. Now there's a huge fucking Venomancer, which is done. And there's the top of agility. Gives me 20 agility. In other words, gives me a little bit more attack speed, which is great. The second one would be Tuska. I'm not killing Tuska. I have to kill Tuska, but I have to pick up the game with the courier later. So, I'm just gonna skip Tuska and run for Silencer, which gives intelligence. Intelligence is not the most preferable stat, I gotta admit that. But it's still not completely rubbish. More intelligence means more mana means... I don't actually know. Nothing good for Alchemist, apparently. Alchemist Scepter is something I can consume as well for stats, and I will do that. As well as my career, actually, so nice. So, now, what about I want to replace? I have Lifesteal now, however. Alright. I forgot what I wanted to Yes, the Basher. I actually need the Basher right now. So, let's get the Basher. Gonna replace that with the Blade. Because the Blade was supposed to be an replacement for the Vine Rapier. But I already have the Vine Rapier. So... it doesn't really matter right now. I just need to stun the shit out of things. It's a physical bash after all. Time for the last one, which is the strength. Okay, the most important stat for Alchemist because it increases my damage and doesn't actually do shit. It's a Sand King. Pretty simple.
Easy now.
Chin chopper, chin chopper. Oh no, both bosses spawned on a remote location. That is fucking rubbish.
Your middle tower is fighting for its life. You know that middle tower that used to be alive and defending itself? Well, that has changed.
I have to get hooked by the bosses. I hope they do that for me. Yes, perfect. Because otherwise I have to run the whole map back and that is not gonna work. So this boss, as you might have seen, does a lot of damage. Alchemist form is up, and then I'm just gonna run and bash them, because I have a lot of attack speed and lifesteal. I can actually do that. Here we go, now I can consume the Aghanims as well. Here we go. Aghanims consumed, perfect. Oh, this is the gyrocopter wave now. Alright then. I have almost 600 attack speed. If I actually have, do I have 600 attack speed? Almost. A few levels more and I will have it on both forms, both with and without my ulti on. Higher than 600 you can't go, by the way, just in case you wondered why I'm wondering for the 600. Alchemist is very much efficient to just get, you know, a lot of other things on. No. I mean, I have 1000 damage as well, do not get me wrong. I attack so fast I can attack the rockets out of the air. Now a second Roche token would actually help a lot, because the second Roche token is pretty great. What it does, and why it should spawn soon, and I hope it does, is because then I can finally get the second level sword. Now there's a high level variant of the sword I'm already having, which is this one. And this one you can get with a Scuddy. No. Obviously. Obviously, I need a fucking token for that as well, so I am inclined not to get it just now. There are certain... there's the Sphere of Odin is a thing I need later, but not right now. There is a Desolator NB, which is also really strong, but not for Alchemist, who works on, works on other heroes better. What else is the Storm Arrow Hunter Sword? I'm looking if there's another one for the Aegis, which would make it useful to pick up an Aegis right now, and apparently the answer to that is no. So I am not gonna do this just now. I'm gonna do it if I can. I will not pick it up just now. I'll pick up it later. What is stuff of Sutters? Oh, it's basically a stuff of the good thing in on Craig. All right, so I don't need the Aegis just now. So because I don't have the gem yet. And if I can get a gem, the first thing I will do is upgrading the fucking veil of, what is this? Can I consume this? I should be able to consume that. What I will be getting when I get those things, however, the first thing I will get is the upgraded Vladimir's. Now, the upgraded Vladimir's, or called Schutzdali's Offering, basically gives me not only a whole bunch of shitty stats, but it also gives me Berserk of Mask of Madness to make things even better. It also gives me Vladimir's at 60% base attack damage. That is so insane. I can sell attack speed items for better items after. Basically. Now I have to chase a few fucking helicopters, sadly. It will take a very long time till they run into the tower, so I have to chase them down. In case you haven't noticed it, without boots, that is actually going to be interesting. Now, the thing is, no trees are cut, so it's pretty simple. I will, at one point, will be able to just stand next to them. This is by far the wave that takes the longest. I should buy boots, maybe get them with a cure, but I don't have the money, so I don't care. One down. Now, time for the second one. Come to my papa. He is really taking it far. Oh, I forgot the Tome of Intelligence. Good to know that I came back here so I could pick it up. More intelligence. It doesn't really do a lot, as I previously said. Oh, by the way, the Sphere of Odin, in case you wonder why. Yeah, that is purely for the Wrath Knight, Wrath King boss. I will replace my my Assault Cuirass for that wave, just because it is incredibly hard to deal with. His stun is the reason why people fail. It is not anything else. His stun every 5 seconds. I can block every second stun. That is completely exactly what I need. Stay frosty. Most annoying wave in the game by a fucking landslide. Give me a TP, Courier. Your middle tower is under attack. So the Ancient Apparitions is what spawns, so we'll not actually come into the fucking battlefield till I killed everything. But then they will commit suicide. So that works for me.
Watch where you're going.
Your middle tower is under attack.
So what, it's really simple. I'm just gonna put this down, they will move faster. I will kill every single creep on this map, and then the Ancient Apparitions come and I can kill them. It is that simple. The Ancient Apparition Ice Blasts, however, do a shit ton more than actual Ice Blasts. They are straight up toxic. Awesome. Alright, they're coming too. Seems like the most of my job consists of running around making sure the mobs actually come to me.
Okie dokie. I'm not ready. Watch your head.
There's one more group I can pull, so let's go there. We're already half an hour in. Eesh. Alright then.
Pour it on.
Running close. Acid spray. Alright, they were in my aura. Now, I pull those. No, they are pulled automatically.
Decanting.
There are a few more not pulled waves I have to deal with. This one is rather easy. I just run here, drop an acid spray there, and kill those fuckers here. So the liches are really dangerous if you don't play alone. The liches have an unlimited biotic frost build. It is absolutely incredibly dangerous. But, well. Obviously, not playing with friends. I have no friends. Ha, I'm joking. Anyway, obviously I'm not playing with friends, so it's not hard for me to not get any damage whatsoever. I wonder, can I consume a second Agon? Can I consume an Agon of Scepter, a second one? I will wonder this now. And if I can't, can I consume the not Agon of Scepter, the other item? I will see this. Oh, my stash is full. Right, courier. You gotta help with that. Did I just buy items into the nowhere? I think I just wasted a shit ton of money. Because if I bought items, I so sure as I can't find them right now. Oh, there they are. What happens exactly when you buy items that you cannot afford inventory space for, I wonder. Hey! Stop murdering me. Huh. Interesting.
Start reacting.
Can you come and die? Awesome.
Watch your step.
Right, while I'm walking, let's find out if I can consume a second Aghanim Scepter. It would be, of course, very interesting if I can.
Stir it up.
Drop the Vladimir's, because in case some Ninja X comes.
Oh ho! Scepter!
Get the fuck away from me. Alright, so I have already one Aghanim's buff, not a brick problem. It was expected. Let's see how it goes when I have this new Aghanim Scepter here. I have to go here fast so I can pull the other wave, and it's just so annoying that I still have to wait for them to come all the way around. I think I'm gonna put my Battle Fury like into the courier and just like make sure that I can have like the Battle Fury on the motherfucking courier in case I ever need it. Well, the celebrations aren't doing anything. Interesting. They should be doing a lot more than they are. Because of that bug I'm having, many things of this is waiting. Quite literally.
I heard you. That's not a thing.
The reason I'm not sure if I can consume two Agana Scepters is because I quite literally didn't try it. As you can see, the Ancestor Apparitions aren't even worth shit. They're literally just here to be annoying. I don't need the High Armor Sword, so I'm just gonna sell it to make sense out of it. This is the Wraith King boss. I need to replace my AC with this. Take the AC. I'll drop everything. Get this, this, and this, and now this. Drop this. Give it to me. I can't. Alright, perfect. You know that fucking experience is wasted. Perfect. Now, I wanna defend till the Wraith King Comet. I have a buyback ready. I have my, what's it called? The resurrection on my sword. You will see what I mean when I die. Because the sword has not only an Aegis, but also some very neat features. Oh, a double damage rune. That is absolutely bloody perfect. Die. So the stun of Wraith King has more cooldown than the Odin Sphere. That makes this boss incredibly easy. I am not gonna lie, this boss is an absolute annoyance to deal with if he permanently keeps a stun. The stun deals such an huge amount of damage, it is not even funny. And the last Wraith King isn't dying in time because he deals too much auto hit damage. Why is he not dying in time? Because he has 45,000 life points and 70 armor. He's just not made for dying. But I'm not made for getting killed, so everything is fine. See, I mean, look at how little damage he takes. Crappy. And also insane, but mostly crappy. I can dodge this with Ember Spirit. Pretty much all the time. Sleight of Fist. Just fucking rules. That's it. Don't have to say anything against that. Right, here we go. Next wave. I'm not sure how long I will be able to hold this up. I think I will be able to hold this up for a good year. Beware the Wolf. Alright, the Wolf wave is interesting. Because it's very strong. But because it is strong, I'm just gonna go here and put my shit, the shit on me. And kill them, pretty much. Sphere of Shin, not Odin. How did I read Odin out of Shin? That doesn't matter. And now I'm gonna hunt for every single bastard, because apparently they're stuck. Who would have thought? Hasted units getting stuck. I want to repeat it. Units getting stuck. Good job, Dota Engine. You are doing your job well. Reborn. Well, as I said, I'm pretty done at this point. The first priority is to upgrade the goddamn Vladimir's. Alright, I wanna back off a little bit just so we can regenerate a few hundred HP, just to make sure that I'm not actually dying on this wave, because that would be god damn it awful. I can buy all the prerequisites for the besiege mail, I guess. And for this as well. Which is Scully, we have further fought. And now I can go for the Vladimir's. In case I'm not having a gem till that point, I can upgrade it with money. Where's the Bloods again? Here we go. Yeah. The Vladimir is the final nail in the coffin, as much attack speed as it adds. Oh, I have to actually kill Tuska and get the gem at one point, and this point should be now. Weaver wave should be wave 20? I'm not sure. So let's just take chances and actually kill Tuska while we can. Enemy's middle tower has fallen. Fuck it. I mean, they are haste. No, alright, they had 400 movement speed and they are not coming. Why? I don't get it. So frustrating. Right. Can I cut with the courier? No, I can't. But I can make Alchemist move here. I said I can make Alchemist move here. Lionize me. Oh, it's Lion Lena. They just ult you, basically. Now I would get this, cut a tree, give him this, take the Vlads, send him back, and, well, pull the creeps again, because the creeps are getting stuck, as always. Stupid creeps. They are pulled. Oh, look, there's the Shadow Shaman, which is the boss, in a way.
Your middle tower is fighting for its life.
And by boss, I mean absolutely and total pushover. Oh. Your middle tower is under attack. I forgot I opened something. In fact. Well, don't worry about it, guys. We will be able to handle this. That would be really interesting if I would fail here. Your middle tower has fallen. Oh, wait, that's the first. Oh, that's a lot of ultis, actually. And the Shadow Shaman shit. Right, me. Oh, did the tree grow back? So it wasn't such a bad thing after all. Hey, Lena, be pulled. Let me just politely remind you that you are pulled. Right, and now it's time to go to this podium and look at this fucker and just be funny about it. You, friendly reminder that you are pulled. Well, so that's how easy it is. Oh, Lion, hi. You're dead. Go fuck yourself. This is growing back. I wanna cut it. Maybe I should upgrade the Battle Fury first, the Fire Soul Cleaver. Just so I have an excuse. No, but Devil's Blade is so important. Ugh, can't do this. Oh no, there's the Flying Wave. The Flying Wave, I dreaded it. It's so hard to fight. Alone. Especially on Alchemist.
Your middle tower has fallen on hard times. Dead times, in fact.
Better get rid of this stuff. Watch your head.
Promise they choose to ignore you. They simply refocus your towers, because they are pussies. Backdooring six of shit. Now this Brock would have actually helped me this time, but nope, I'm not getting it. Whatever. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Hey, you die before you do some stupid shit. While you're at it, my ensigns should be staying alive. Thank you very much.
Hey, you're making me spill.
Your agent is being stabbed.
Dudes, what the fuck are you doing? Alright, I need boots for this. Definitely.
Oh, your ancient isn't happy with you right now.
Just a little bit faster, please. Alchemist, I'm not asking too much. You're a friend of mine, forget about that. Fuck. The ancient is almost down. Alright, if I hurry, I can save this. If not, I die on the flying wave. No! Oh! So close. I should have bought a little bit of boots first, but I didn't. It was the last flying group too. Well, No, you could do about it. This is one that, like, this I have not practiced this wave, to be honest. I was not preparing it to be here. Hey, this is Solo Alchemist going all the way to wave 16, and if you're not completely shit, then I will be able to maybe do this again if the game goes on Game of the Day mode. So, we'll see. Maybe I find a different hero which even works better than Alchemist. Now, Alchemist works obviously very good because of the early gold, but there's gonna be other heroes that work well, right? Sure. I mean, sure, why not? I just don't know which one yet. We'll see. I'm taking requests, by the way. If you want me to see a certain hero, then just go ahead. Ask for it. No, I'm serious. Ask for it. I'm gonna take requests. See you later. Aftermath signing out. And don't forget I can go back in time by watching my old videos on the playlist I have safely arranged for you on my channel. Also, do go back in time. Also, you can go in the future by subscribing to my channel. And if you go into the future, well, guess what? You'll see all the videos when they just came out. Wow, mind-blowing, isn't it? Now, don't forget, likes help a lot, but dislikes also help if you can tell me why you disliked, because then I can do it better. In any case, I would like you to subscribe so you can stay around for me. To show you that I am at heart trying to get better. After signing out, thanks for watching. See you guys next time.
Do it! Just do it! Don't let your dreams be dreams. Yesterday, you said tomorrow. So just do it! Make your dreams come true! Just do it! Nothing is impossible! No! What are you waiting for? Do it! Just do it! Yes, you can! Just do it! Stop giving up.